this month's edition of Inside OPSU. I'm Danae Moore, the Campus Communications Director at Panhandle State, and I'll be your host. Today we have a special treat in store as we're going to celebrate homecoming festivities on campus. I also have co-hosting with me Matt Sparks, a senior here at Panhandle State. Good morning, Matt.
How's it going, Danae? It's great to be here. This is the most exciting homecoming I've been a part of since I've been here. It seems like it's going to be a huge event. And for me, this is a good opportunity. I've worked with OPSU for a while now, worked with the Sports and Information Department all this year, and it's going to be a good opportunity to sit out here and see the parade. It's a little cold, but I think it's going to be fine.
Well, we're happy to have you. As Matt mentioned, we'll take a look at the homecoming parade. We also get to be a part of the Honored Family Tree recognition as we meet the Ettbauer family and dedicate the tree to them. And later on, we'll meet the homecoming candidates. Sit back and enjoy.
Good morning. We are here in No Man's Land, historic Oklahoma Panhandle State University. For the last 39 years, what we have done is we've always honored a family that means something to the region, somebody who really stands as a legacy and an example for all of us to follow. I'm here today with the Ettbauer family. Well, first things first to the Ettbauer family, thank you so much. I tried to make a joke, you know, about my heroes always being cowboys, and I noticed everybody but the Ettbauers in the room laughed, so thank you so much for that. In all seriousness, though, what you've meant to this university and what you've meant to this region is really incalculable. I mean, you've done so much to bring pride and to bring honor, and I'm not just talking about Robert and Danny and Billy. I'm also talking about Trell and Shade and Chansey, and everybody's just done such a wonderful job. And from our perspective, I talk all the time about the next level for us. And the only way you get to the next level is if you can stand on the shoulders of giants. Your family are some of those giants. And I've noticed something about the Ettbauers. Y'all don't take compliments very well, but please listen to that. We feel like we're standing on your shoulders and you're truly giants. We're honored to do this for you today. I'm honored that you're all here today. Lyle and Bev, I know you've got to be some of the most proud parents. I've got two little boys, and I pray to God that my two boys turn out as good as all of your family has. Well, just everything they've done. So, as I understand it, you're going to say something to us, and I can't wait to hear it, because Bev told me it's going to be great. All right? I tell you what, I'll just hold this, and you just talk to me about what this means.
Well, you know, if you knew how this deal started out and how it ended, is unreal. Who'd ever believe that these ornery little kids had ever turned out like this? And you guys have treated up great down here in Oklahoma. You're really proud of this country. And they had a tough life. It was tough getting where they're at. They've worked at it hard. And thank God for the way the good Lord looking out for them and keeping them safe in their travels. And because, I mean, that van flew kind of like an airplane a lot of the time. And good Lord kept them healthy and everything. So thank you for everything.
Thank you so much. It's true. It was really the travel in between the rodeos that was dangerous, wasn't
you
it?
You bet. And
yeah.
I was always afraid somebody would pull out in front of them.
Right.
Because that van didn't know what the speed limit was. It was seeing 85 at night. So. One of the favorite deals, Danny and Dave Appleton made the short go at Calgary. And then they made the short go in Cheyenne the next day. Well, Dave Appleton, he told Danny, well, why don't you stay with me tonight? And he said, we'll get on an airplane. Lottie died down there in the morning. And Danny said, no, he said, I think I'll ride with Billy because Billy's up here all by himself. So they went down to Cheyenne. They got there in time to shower and take a nap and stuff. Dave Appleton, one plane missed, and you know how that is. He got there just in time for his event. And Danny said, geez, Dave, you should have rode with us. You'd got to take a nap.
That's a great story. I also want to mention Sue. She's somebody who really makes our rodeo team go. And we're so proud of everybody. Chansey, we're glad you're happy and healthy and back with us. So thank you so much for all of this. We're honored. With your permission, I think what we're going to do is take a picture. And we're going to put you on a float. And we're going to do a parade. So thank you all so much for being here.
Good morning and welcome to the 2017 Homecoming Parade. Today's theme is Wild with Pride.
And we're set up for a football game here later as the OPSU Aggies get set to take on the number 8 ranked Langston University Lions. Coming up first is Andy Ramirez leading the Boy Scouts color guard for the homecoming parade, as is the tradition.
Let's give Chief Ramirez a hand. We'll catch the Boy Scouts later at the game as they present the colors as well. Thank y'all.
Next up, we have Panhandle State President Dr. Fulton and his family. Dr. Fulton is the 15th president at Panhandle State.
He's joined by his wife Kelly and their sons Rex and Max. Hi guys. Special thanks to Draper Farms for the awesome ride. Looking good, guys.
Next up, we have 2016 Fall Homecoming King and Queen, Rainey Anderson and Mackenzie Twyman, also riding in a car furnished by Draper Farms. Give them a wave, Rainey.
Halo King and Queen are next up. Each year, Panhandle State sponsors the Fiesta Royalty Scholarship Competition. We've done that for the past 20 years, and you can see Lupita Jimenez and Jose Lopez, this year's King and Queen. Thank you all. It looks like we have the School of Ag float. The School of Ag strives to unite in the hunt for the Langston Lions. They are wild with pride.
Next up, we have the Panhandle State Association of Alumni and Friends.
Guess you wait till you see him, he just knows two people that are in Dubai. So,
the Ettmauer family is riding the 2017 Honored family. Shout out to Jana, our spirit rider.
And here comes Aggie Nation, represented by the Aggie cheer team and athletes.
Check out No Man Dan, give us a wave.
Next, we have the Halloween Halftime Band, directed by Panhandle State's very own Sharla Lewis. The band will perform a show at halftime today at the game. Area high schools are here for the day to work with college and athletic bands to develop the show. Team coached by Kayla Hook.
Give us a wave, girls.
And coming up, we have Goodwill Middle School football and cheer, led by Carrie Jo Blickenstaff. Next up, we have the PBL float, that's Phi Beta Lambda, featuring the mascot and the Langston University Lion.
Next up, we have the Panhandle State Shooting Sports Club, featuring wild animals, guns, and archery equipment that they use in the pursuit of their sport. Broadcasting it on PTCI Channel 2, your leader in broadband and communication services for the Oklahoma Panhandle.
We have the Northwest Domestic Crisis Services, represented by Matthew Crook. Good to have y'all.
Next up, we have the Memorial Hospital of Texas County Authority. Give everybody a wave. Coming up next, we have the float from Zach's Cheese. Be sure to remember Zach's Cheese this holiday season for all your fundraisers, gift certificates, and more. Everybody staying warm out there? Let's hear some Aggie pride.
Woo woo! Next up, we have Families for Templin, Travis Templin for Senate.
And behind that, we have the supporters of Carolyn McLarty for State Senate District 27. We'd like to thank everybody for coming out to the 2017 Homecoming Parade for the inaugural Oklahoma A&M Showdown, and we'll see y'all at the game.
Be sure to join us in the tailgate zone for the barbecue. We're live in the tailgate zone. I'm here with our homecoming candidates. Hi, Sam.
Hi, nice to meet you.
I'm going to let you go ahead and introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about you.
All right, too easy. My name's Sam Lemin. I'm a senior here at OPESU. I'm an accounting and finance major, and I'm from Canberra, Australia.
Australia, that's awesome. Tell us what brought you here.
Well, football, of course. I mean, that's what brought me here initially, and I've stayed for the family and friends here, and I'm still playing football, so can't complain.
Are you ready for the showdown today?
Of course.
It's a big game. Ready.
Oh, yes, very big game.
So what's your favorite thing about Panhandle State?
Definitely has to be the family and friendly atmosphere. Just everyone here is so kind, and obviously being abroad, it's hard. You get homesick at times, but the friends and family just keep me here, and it's just awesome, and everyone's so kind.
What do you feel makes Panhandle State a step ahead of the rest? Where you've come all this way, there's got to be plenty of things keeping you here, and you've touched on it a bit, just the family atmosphere. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, well, family atmosphere and also the teachers. I mean, the small class environment really helps me a lot, and the teachers seem to really care a lot, and they are more than willing to aid you in whatever problems you have. Obviously, traveling with football, the teachers are more than willing to work with you in terms of assignments and classwork, so it's just a great thing.
All right, well, congratulations
Thank
on your
you
nomination.
Much.
We'll catch you on the field.
Likewise, thank you very much.
I'm back with another one of our homecoming candidates. Riley, I'll let you introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Riley. I'm from Texoma, and I am majoring in business administration with an emphasis in marketing, and I'm minoring in education.
Congratulations on your nomination. That's
Thank
super
you.
Exciting.
Thank you.
So you're very close to home, obviously,
yes.
Only 10 miles away. What made you decide to stay this close to home?
So I'm a part of the Lady Aggie golf team, and that's what made me stay close to home, and it just gave me so many opportunities that being this close to home, I have so many jobs, and it's just very helpful that I'm close to home.
So what are some of the other activities you are involved in?
I'm involved in PBL, which is Phi Beta Lambda, in the business department, and then I'm involved in FCA. I'm involved in SAC, which is the Student Athlete Advisory Committee.
Lots of different things.
Yes.
I'm sure all of those will be very helpful for the future. Is there anything that sticks out to you about your favorite part about being here?
Well, I just love being this close to home, and it's just an amazing campus. You get one-on-one with teachers, and it's just a great place to be. It's very homey.
Awesome. Well, thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Best wishes in the coronation.
Thank you.
All right, I am here with homecoming candidate Jasmine Brown Jutris, and she's a candidate for the 2017 Homecoming Queen. And what would you like to say to the people out there?
I would just like to say how much of an honor it is to be chosen by the student body to be a candidate for Homecoming Queen. It really is truly an honor. Thank you.
And what's your major here at OPSU?
I'm a music education major, and I'm a senior, and I'll graduate in May.
Absolutely. And what are your classes like as a music education major? Sorry.
Music education majors have a crazy schedule. My day is an 8-to-5 day normally. It's pretty crazy.
All right. And have you enjoyed homecoming so far?
Oh, absolutely. I love homecoming. I love this time of the year. There's always so many people on campus. So many people are excited. All the spirit. It's really fun.
All right. Well, thank you for being with us, and enjoy the rest of the festivities.
Thank you.
All right, I'm here with homecoming candidate Cedar Sasse, who is a forward on the Oklahoma Panhandle State University Aggie basketball team. How does it feel to be selected as a homecoming candidate,
Cedar? It's definitely an honor. This is something new to me, so I'm just soaking in everything. This is a great experience right now, most definitely.
And what class are you in? You a junior, senior?
I'm a senior.
And what's your major?
My major is sports management and exercise.
Absolutely. And what are your classes like as a sports management major?
It basically prepares me to, because I want to be a coach after this, so mm-hmm. just giving me all the skills that I need, management skills, so I could just coach at the highest level possible.
Sounds like a rough schedule.
Yes, sir.
And have you enjoyed homecoming so far?
Yeah, the school spirit, everyone's alive, we're here. You got to beat Langston, man. This is a big
Absolutely.
Game. Yes, sir.
All right, thank you for being with us,
Cedar. I appreciate Cedar. It, thank you.
You have a good afternoon. Enjoy
yes,
the rest of the festivities.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate it.
And we're back with another homecoming candidate. Ellie, I know you've been on this show a couple of times, and we're excited to have you again. Can you introduce yourself for those that may not have met you yet?
Yeah, for sure. My name is Ellie Espel. I am from Guymon, Oklahoma. I am a senior in college. And I'm
Already?
Yeah, I know. It's gone by so fast. And I'm an elementary education major with a minor in business and physical science. All right, that is so awesome. We're very glad to have you. Like I said, excited for the coronation. We wish you the best of that.
Thanks. Yeah, I'm so excited. We'll see what happens, but yeah.
Okay, you are close to home. Guyman's only 10 miles away. What made Panhandle State stick out to you? What makes you think, I mean, what would you say, how could you highlight it as a step above other universities?
I think what I would highlight as a step above other universities is just how small it is and how, like, you know everybody. I know friends who go to, you know, bigger universities and they're like, oh my gosh, Ellie, we have to schedule when we see each other because you won't bump into each other because that's how big the universities are, that you literally have to plan out. Here you'll see everyone maybe 3 or 4 times a day and, you know, it's just nice and neat. Everybody knows you and, I mean, again, it's close to home. I have my family, you know, close by. They're there for me. I mean, it's made college so easy, and I think that's really added to my success in college, having my family and the support and, you know, having home-cooked meals every, you know, often and not being all on my own and stuff, but yeah.
Well, we're very proud of you. You've done amazing things while you're here. Is there any one thing that sticks out as your favorite? I know you're very involved in lots of things. Maybe a couple even that you want to highlight.
I love everything I do. That's why I do it all. But a few things that I, you know, love about OPSU would be like the students in it. I am the student government president and I just love it. Everyone is so involved and just so excited to be there. They want to be there. They want to, you know, contribute to our school and our community. And the next thing would have to be the after school program. I love it. I love my kids. They're actually here and they're like, Miss Ellie, we hope you win. And they're just, oh, it's
Homecoming
so exciting.
2017,
but yeah, those are my two favorite things.
That's awesome. Well, we wish you the best and thanks for joining us.
Yes, thank you so much. We'll see you guys.
Don't forget it.
We're back with another homecoming candidate. David, it's nice to have you. I'll let you introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm David Peebles. I'm from Hermitage, Arkansas.
And you are majoring in?
Health and physical education.
And you're a senior this year, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Arkansas, that's a ways away.
Oh, yes it is, about 13 hours.
What brought you here?
Actually to be in the band.
Okay, and you're very involved on campus. Tell me some of the activities you were in.
So some of the activities that I'm in: History Club, SOEA Club, NAFME, and OIO.
Okay, today's a special day for the band. Do you want to tell me a little bit about that?
Yeah, so today we're actually getting a lot of high schoolers here, and we're going to do a Halloween halftime show today.
That sounds like a lot of fun. Neat for you guys to be able to interact with them as well and show them what you've learned during your time here.
Oh, yeah, and it's a great way for us to, like, just kind of build just like a form of, like, of a bond for them too, because this is a memory that they will always have.
For sure. Can you tell me what your favorite thing is about Panhandle State?
I think my favorite thing is probably due to the fact that, like, in the home of the Oklahoma Panhandle, even though I live so far away, it's just like a family here. I mean, I can go visit anyone's house and they accept me just like their own.
That's awesome. Well, we're very glad to have you as part of the Aggie family, and we wish you the best with today's coronation.
Thank you.
All right, I'm here with Matthew Carter, and today we're going to talk about these beautiful pieces of art behind us that were apparently fired in the bonfire last night.
Yes, it's called a pit firing. It's been done for thousands of years. You take your ceramics, put it in a pit, cover it with sawdust, wood, a bunch of colorants, and let it burn, and you end up with pieces like this.
And approximately how long does a process like this take?
Well, we built the pit yesterday morning and put our pieces in it and made the bonfire, and I think we got it started about 9 last night, and then at 4 o'clock this morning we started taking pieces out, cleaning those off, and I think we wrapped everything up about 7 in the morning.
So what you're saying is that participants in homecoming can actually buy a piece of the homecoming festivities.
Oh yes, this is ceramic students from the OPSU art department, and they'd be more than willing to sell some of these.
All right, and who all participated in the firing of these pieces?
Oh gosh, let me try to remember. I'm going to forget somebody. Brent Shoulders, AJ Ingo, Dustin Martinez, Sam Ortiz, Sandra Elliott, and I believe Alyssa Livingston, and myself.
Absolutely. That is fascinating. Thank you for being with us today, Matt.
problem.
And enjoy the festivities.
All right, thank you.
I'm here with Oklahoma Panhandle State Associate Professor of Art Brent Shoulders, and we spoke with Matthew Carter earlier a little bit about the firing of these pieces here in the background. Could you tell us a little more about it, about the history behind it?
It's kind of a fun history, just simply because I always, you know, when I teach class, I always try to talk to the students about the different styles, different processes, different firing methods. Well, the cool thing is, with this, where did it come from? You know, we look back and we think, okay, was it a kid making a mud pie and he actually set it in a fire, cooked it, hardened it? Is that part of it? Is that really what kicked it off? We don't know. You know, cave paintings, were they children's paintings? You know, that sort of thing. So when we got to looking at this, it's just such a primitive process, and you can't really beat big flames, lots of smoke, fire, singed hair. There's just so much action, so much fun in doing it. And then the fact that it's in the bottom of this massive fire, and we're sitting there, you're at the mercy of the fire, number one. So any piece, anything in the world could happen to it. But just that, I guess the mystery, the unknown as to what's going to happen, is kind of the exciting part. But, you know, we've been trying to get this pulled off and put together for several years. But this year, you know, we asked and they said, oh, absolutely, let's rock and roll. So we jumped on the opportunity and really had a blast with it. Came out, you know, the ice storm that came through it was last year, ripped things up, that we had tons of lumber. We were able to build a pretty good bonfire, burned really hot, and surprisingly got to temperatures much, much higher than we initially expected. So
that's amazing. So are they planning to make this a homecoming tradition now?
Is this
yes.
your bonfire pottery?
Yes, it is.
Oh, how cool. Hey,
well, thank you for being with us, Brent.
Oh, you bet.
We look forward to seeing more pieces in the future.
Absolutely.
Hello and welcome to Anchor D Bank Stadium. Tonight, we are set to give you and kick off our homecoming game. It's time to find out who this year's fall homecoming king and queen are. But first, we'd like to bring out our reigning king and queen, Ramey Anderson and Mackenzie Twyman, the fall 2016 royalty. Thank you two for representing the university well throughout the year. We'd also like to introduce this year's homecoming crown bearers, Miss Tagrin Moore, daughter of Danae and David Moore, and Max Fulton, son of University President Dr. Tim Fulton and his wife, Kelly. Let's give them a round of applause, everyone. And now let's meet our 2017 fall homecoming candidates. Our first couple to take the field is Sam Lamen and Jasmine Brown Hutras. Sam is a senior from Canberra, Australia. His parents are Kathy and Gray Lamen. He has a degree in accounting and business administration and has received a president's honor roll 5 times, dean's honor roll, 7th place in cost accounting at NLC with PBL. He is involved in student senate treasurer of PBL, former RA of Holter Hall, and of course, is on your Panhandle State football team. After graduation, Sam intends to take the CPA exam and join a big accounting firm. Jasmine is a senior from Hermitage, Arkansas. Her parents are Nicole Jutras and Gregory Hilliard. She is pursuing a degree in music education. She's received honors as an OIL delegation chair, Oklahoma Student Government Association state vice president, Oklahoma Intercollegiate Legislature director of recruitment, OPSU student government president, National Association for Music Educator president and treasurer. She's involved in the Oklahoma Intercollegiate Legislature, NAFME, OPSU SGA, Oklahoma SGA, Cross Country, SOEA, and presently involved in HALO and PBL. After graduation, Jasmine plans to continue on becoming a music educator while still working in policy and advocacy. I and your next couple, Sita Cisse and Ellie Esquivel. Sita is a senior from Harlem, New York, and his parents are Sarah Caba and Lehman Cisse. He's pursuing a degree in sports management and exercise and has received a 2016-2017 Aggies Men's Basketball Defensive Player of the Year. He's involved in men's basketball and your Aggie band bass drum, and also volunteers to train kids in the Noble to help improve their basketball skills. After graduation, Sita plans to move to California and coach basketball and train kids. He wants to give back to the community any way possible. Ellie is a senior from Guymon, Oklahoma. Her parents are Ramiro and Esperanza Esquivel. She plans to pursue a degree in elementary education with minors in business administration and physical science. She has received the honor of being selected to serve on the presidential search committee, which hired Dr. Fulton, as well as the honor of being asked by Dr. Fulton to speak at the state capitol for Higher Education Day. She's received the Student Oklahoma Education Association Outstanding Local Leader Award, as well as first place in a Phi Beta Lambda Future Business Educator competition and placed in finals at Nationals, as well as receiving a President and Dean's Honor Roll. She's involved in the Hispanic American Leadership Organization Student Senate Representative, Oklahoma Intercollegiate Legislature Member, Student Senate Correspondent Secretary, Secretary, and now President, the Student Oklahoma Education Association local and state president, as well as a member of Phi Beta Lambda English Club and the Baptist Collegiate Ministries and the Methodist Student Center. She serves on the OPSU Teacher Education Council, Student Conduct Committee, and Academic Council. In addition, she serves on the Oklahoma Education Association Board of Directors, and she's also a teacher for the after-school program, Panhandle's Future. After graduation, Ellie plans to do missionary work overseas and attend grad school at the Oklahoma State University in the fall. The next couple, David Peebles and Riley Paige Higgins. David is a senior from Hermitage, Arkansas, and his parents are Robert and Annette Peebles. He's pursuing a degree in health and physical education. He is a two-time Dean Honor Roll, Outstanding Instrumentalist, and Head RA of Holter Hall. He's involved in NAFME, SOEA, OIL, and Vice President of History Club, Student Government Parliamentarian, Resident Assistant for Field Hall, OPSU, Corvette Band and Choir, OPSU Athletic Band, and after graduation, David plans to get a master's degree in education and coach football. Riley Paige Higgins is a sophomore out of Texoma, Oklahoma. Her parents are Greg and Trina Higgins, and she's pursuing a degree, bachelor's in business administration with an emphasis in marketing and a minor in education. She's involved in Phi Beta Lambda, Fellowship of Christian Athletes, Student Athlete Advisory Committee, University Photographer, and the Lady Aggie Golf Team. After graduation, Riley plans to teach high school business classes and open a home decor and clothing boutique. Let's hear it for your homecoming candidate. And now it's time to see who your winners are. Can I get a drum roll from the band, please? I'd like to introduce your 2017 Panhandle State Fall Homecoming King and Queen. This year's King is Sita Cisse. And your homecoming queen, Jasmine Brown Jutras. Let's give them a big round of applause, everyone. Congratulations, Jasmine and Sita. We look forward to a great year ahead. Let's hear it one more time for your homecoming royalty. The Hall of Fame induction ceremony and banquet will take place tonight at 6 p.m. in the Student Union Ballroom, and these four great individuals will be honored for their outstanding athletic contributions to Oklahoma Panhandle State University. Please help me welcome David Flowers, Bob Wakefield, Georgia Walton, and the family of Mr. Jerry Linton. Let's hear it for your Aggie Hall of Fame class of 2017. Congratulations to everyone. The Panhandle State Association of Alumni and Friends would like to introduce the honored family of 2017, the Ettbauer family. The Ettbauers have been involved with the rodeo program at Panhandle State since 1981. They have contributed to the continued success of the program for many years, including being team member, coaches, and supporters. Currently, the head coach of our rodeo team, Robert, has also been inducted into the Panhandle State Alumni Hall of Fame, and with his brother, Billy, was inducted into the Pro Rodeo Hall of Fame in 2012. In 2013, Robert, Billy, and Danny were all inducted in the Rodeo Hall of Fame in Oklahoma City. Additional family members and Panhandle State supporters include their parents, Lyle and Bev Ettbauer, a sister, Wanda Sisson, and her family, as well as children and grandchildren, many of whom are also OPSU alumni. The family are big supporters of the Panhandle State Rodeo Team. They make trips to Goodwill every spring for the Bronc Riding School and continue to support Robert and Sue in their role at the helm of the legendary Panhandle State Rodeo Program. Not only has the Ettbauer family written their own chapter in rodeo's history books, they have helped numerous other cowboys and cowgirls to write their own. Let's hear it for the Ettbauer family. And finally, welcome to the OPSU's Halloween 3 Halftime Show. We'd like to take this time to recognize the participants. OPSU's Aggie Band, Oklahoma students from Turpin and Texoma, Kansas students from Liberal, Rolla, and Ulysses, and New Mexico students from Clayton. These students met and put this show together for the first time this morning in freezing temperatures, then marched in the homecoming parade as a mass band. They'd like to thank their parents, directors, and other supporters for being here today and supporting them in all of their endeavors. Today's show features these students performing Wild Thing, The Haunted Gate at Kiev, and I Want Candy. Enjoy and happy Halloween. Let's give it up for your OPSU Halloween 3 halftime show.
Thank you for joining us today. We hope you enjoyed the homecoming festivities, and that's what's happening on campus.